As you might know, in the last devlog, made in the 10th of November, I said I started porting the game to God of War, and it was being a disaster. Well, in the meantime, there has been 11 attempted rewrites, and my latest video got metric buttloads of videos, I had gazillions of subscribers, my channel will be qualified for monetization when I upload this video, and a niche internet micro-celebrity commented on the video. It was some interesting months, to say the least. I have no idea how to transition to the actual video, so
I'm gonna update to Go.version 4.20 and .NET 8. Going from using 1 year old software to using negative old software, oh my god emoji. .NET 8 will release in a few days, Go.4.20 is supposed to release this month, holy moly. I can't change the graphics settings until I load a project. Yes.
So the first problem was trying to get it to compile. In God of War, every property, function, and class under the sun has been renamed. Not only that, quite a few systems have been completely remade, such as the file system system. I also then noticed that I wasn't supposed to save the new .godo folder in version control, and while trying to fix that, I made it enter an eternal loop of re-importing assets. After I got Godo to acknowledge the existence of my C# code, I got 42 build errors. While fixing them, I got wowed by the new C# features such as file scope namespaces and switch expressions, which were being suggested by the new C# dev kit extension. Anyways, after I fixed the 42 errors, I tried compiling again, and got 393 build errors. And when I fixed the 393 errors, I got 126 more errors, which is unfortunate. 2 days later, the game compiled successfully in C# for the first time. So now it was time for the actual fixes, starting with the theme, boot screen, and onboarding screen, and then I quickly got the LELS top to look somewhat correct, but I still had to fix the Windows system, which would be tricky since God of War introduces a brand new window node based on viewports instead of pop-ups. While I was trying to fix window animations, my key broke. But now that the game started somewhat properly, I had a brilliant idea. What if I try to make this single beta version of the game obnoxiously large? I had fantastic ideas, such as a completely different LELS top for the mobile version, and redesigning every app to work better on mobile, but as you will see later, that was just the beginning. I fixed every theme, and turned the window test app into a UI test app, where you can test all kinds of irrelevant bullshit. I then tried fixing workspaces. It refused to work with the new window system, the new window system refused to work with anything for that matter. And then I didn't have internet for a week. Anyways, 0.10, the version before God of War, had a custom sound and music system. It was awful, so I decided to replace it with a cool plugin I found on the interwebs. I then renamed the game and several internal parts, and it got twice as broken, which is a technical feat of astounding proportions considering that absolutely nothing worked. The next victim was the saving system. The current one was perfectly fine, but you needed a bit more code than necessary sometimes. So I made a new system using fancy OOP patterns such as polymorphism, and it would structure bullshit in a more elegant way, which would make every single previous version completely incompatible, but this version was already completely incompatible with reality, so I also got sick when I started making this new save system, which is probably why it fucking sucked and was comically broken, and it only took me fixing 213 errors to find that out. I also remembered that GDScript existed, and decided to use it for really simple scripts such as a progress bar made solely for wasting your time. So now I redesigned the boot screen and login screen for absolutely no reason, and I remade the saving system, again, and fixed metric buttloads of errors. If that wasn't enough shit fuckery for you, I also remade the calculator's code, as if there weren't bigger problems. One of the few good things that came out of this update was my experiments with translations. And it turns out that Godo makes it pretty easy. I also noticed that the wallpapers folder was 20 megabytes, so I did epic compression bullshit, and also added 4 more wallpapers, but then I remembered the game was still completely and utterly dysfunctional. Flabbergasting. So I remade the settings app, with more pointless bullshit than ever, tried to fix window snapping and it didn't work, tried to fix quick launch and it didn't work, the update was a complete disaster. I tried fixing the files app, and while the fake file system worked perfectly fine, I had the brilliant idea to make it use composition and shit. This single beta version was already comically large and I wanted to make it even bigger, so I added to my to-do list great things, such as a more advanced file system, a new system to help apps communicate, an all-new website system, several new games, a brand new installer, a high contrast theme, and the Tor app, and as you can tell, that's a bit too much for a single beta version. But then, the incident happened. On a fateful Wednesday night, I tried testing the new version on Android, and got helpful error messages such as, app not installed as package appears to be invalid. Googling it said it might be related to supported architectures. Supposedly you had to enable 32-bit support for it to work, however Godot 420 didn't allow exporting C# to 32-bit, my phone was an average phone from the second last generation, so you would think it's 64-bit, and no Godot related information appeared. Only general Android stuff. I tried making a new test project just in case, and C# still didn't work on Android, so I tried making a GD script test project, and it also didn't work, until I enabled 32-bit, and it worked flawlessly. But remember, I can't enable 32-bit with C#. My disappointment was immeasurable and my day was ruined. In a single day I went through the 5 stages of grief, denial, this isn't real, anger, fuck, bargaining, I'm gonna rewrite the entire game, should I use COBOL? Depression, I'm gonna murder the creator of Android, and acceptance, I should create my own game engine, laughing out loud. Things only went downhill from here. I had settled on making my own engine for some fucking reason, and I first tried using Monogame with C#, as C# is quite epic. Monogame felt like Java, so I decided to not use it. At this point my last video was just a silly side project, but here I decided to finally finish the project. As you've seen in the video, stay tuned for next year's Get It Devlog, where I discover new kinds of pain. That turned out to be very correct, since I didn't like Monogame, I then tried Kotlin with LWJGL rolls off the tongue, which is the technology behind the game engine behind Minecraft. I had to deal with Gradle for it to work, and that gave me crippling depression. I then remembered that libgdx is a thing, and it has a functional project generator. WOWIE, and libgdx was fine for a Flappy Bird clone, but while Kotlin was pretty nice, I had to deal with libgdx feeling like Java, IntelliJ being slow as hell, and Gradle still being a massive pile of shit. Gradle gave me crippling depression, so then I considered making a simple application in both Rust and C++, without having to deal with some dumb library. I couldn't understand Rust at all, and then I tried making that simple application in C++, and shout out to the Cherno. Thanks to him I now know that C and C++ allow human-made horrors beyond compression with include and define. What he couldn't help with though was the C++ build systems, notice that systems is plural.
Knock knock. Race condition, who's there? Did you get the reference? Do you need any pointers? How to implement STL2 into Xamarin.Android. I am incapable of solving this problem and my brain has fried in the process.
I then found Silk.net, which is like LWJGL but for C#. Making a triangle show up on desktop was very easy, but making it work on Android was, to put it lightly, absolutely abysmal. I even made a little concept for my own programming language, featuring no semicolons and parentheses, immutability unless you write an extra keyword, no exceptions, explicit references with reference counting, pattern matching, fancy enums, requirements to validate arguments at compile time, and it would compile to ADLL that would get linked into a C++ program. Allowing to take advantage of C++'s cross-platform abilities and libraries, while also allowing for blazingly fast compile time since this language wouldn't have 100 keywords like C++. I then found out about Hacks, which is like JavaScript if it wasn't god-awful, it compiles to every language under the sun. So I first tried Car, and it used Electron, which was unfortunate, so I then tried Lime, and it was fine, except that the documentation barely existed, null was used everywhere. And having to implement your own renderer is quite unfortunate, so I then tried OpenFL, and it was much simpler and had a real documentation, but then I found out there's no built-in way to change the origin point of an image, so I tried HacksFlixel, and I barely even tried it, because I remembered something insane: GD script worked on Android. So I had a brilliant idea: rewrite the game in GD script, but also make my language concept real as a side project, since why not at this point?